everyone. It's Mackie from the Children's Museum of the Arts in New York City. Today, we're talking about light. Sometimes light can guide our path. It can tell us when to stop and go. And sometimes light can also be a feeling of hope and weightlessness, and that feeling we get when we share our strengths and gifts with others. When things get dark and gloomy, poet Maya Angelou reminds us, nothing can dim the light that shines from within. How will you share your light with the world? Let's explore on CMA's Lesson of the Week. First, we're going to look at a piece of art, and then we're going to make an art project inspired by that artwork, and then finally, we'll share our artwork that we created. So let's get started. You know that feeling of energy and hope I mentioned earlier? That's how I feel when I look at Rico Gatson's Icon series. When I look at a piece of art, I like to first take in the whole thing. So let's look. What do you see? I see a few things. First, my eye is immediately drawn to these big, colorful lines that go across the whole page, except for this small image down here. To me, it looks like a photo, and it's in black and white, so maybe it's an old photograph? Once I've looked at an artwork as a whole, I like to go back and look for small details to see what I notice or what questions I might have. So let's look again. What do you notice this time? After getting a closer look, I noticed some other things. First, I recognized the colors black, green, red, orange, and yellow in the lines that were used. And I wondered, if the artist had all the colors of the rainbow to choose from, why did they choose these colors? That must mean they're important. Plus, I noticed that all of these lines are coming from this central image. They start smaller when they're connected to the image and grow bigger as they grow out on the page. And when I was looking closer at that image, I realized who it was. Shirley Chisholm, the first black woman elected to the United States Congress and a representative from right here in New York. I noticed that she's holding a microphone, so maybe she's saying something important? This artwork is a part of Rico Gatson's Icon series, in which he honors the many important, meaningful, and powerful people in black culture. The people in these artworks use their strengths and power, their inner light, to bring hope, joy, and make an impact in their world. Rico Gatson also did a related installation in The Bridge, one of CMA's exhibition spaces. Installation is a kind of art that transforms a space and the way you perceive it. Rico Gatson's You Are Light uses beams of light and color as a metaphor for positive energy, power, and hope for a better future. The cool thing is, the artwork is completed when you, the viewer, stand in it. What are your strengths? And what makes you feel powerful? Let's explore as we make an art project inspired by the work of Rico Gatson. So, I've been thinking. Artist Rico Gatson asks us to honor and uplift the people in his artwork, not just for their recognizable image, but more so because of their enduring light and impact they've had on us and our culture. They made this impact by sharing their strength and power with the world. I don't know about you, but I haven't been feeling very strong or powerful lately. There's a lot of things in the world right now that are kind of scary, and when it's raining outside, it's hard to see the light. But then I remembered, the figures in these artworks don't have light shining down on them. They create the light themselves. Nothing can dim the light that shines from within. So I wanted to make a project today where we explore our own inner light, our strengths and our powers, so that no matter what, and even on the darkest days, our inner light can brighten our homes and our communities. So let's begin. Today you'll just need a few things for your artwork. We'll start out with paper, pencils, drawing materials like colored pencils or crayons, scissors, and glue. You're also welcome to use colored paper and collage materials if you'd like. We'll begin by drawing an image of ourselves, a self-portrait. You can use drawing materials, you can cut out pictures from magazines, or use a real photograph of yourself. You decide. As you're creating, think about what your light is that you can share with the world. What makes you a good friend? What are you proudest of? Don't forget to make your self-portrait small so it can fit on the page with all the big, colorful lines of light. Here's the image I made. When I was thinking about my strengths and powers, I thought about how I love to learn and I love to grow. So in my image, which I kept small to fit on my page, I included flowers as a symbol of growth and change, and I also am wearing my CMA shirt, a place where I love to learn. As you're creating, don't forget to think about where this light comes from. Shirley Chisholm's came from her big, powerful voice, Charlie Parker's from his instrument, and Muhammad Ali's from his fist. Where will yours come from? Your powerful mind, your kind heart, your helping hands? When you have your self-portrait complete, it's time to add your light. What colors are you going to use? You decide what colors you'd like to share your strength and power with the world. I also chose to cut out my self-portrait and glue it on top of my page with lines. And so now that that's all done, here is my final self-portrait. And now it's time for our share. Hang your light portrait in a place you'll see it every day. And don't forget to keep sharing your light with the world. It will brighten your home and make our community a better place to be. You can also share your artwork with me and my friends at CMA. Post it to social media and use the hashtag CMANYChallenge. Thanks for joining us for this lesson of the week. We'll see you next time. Bye!
CMA is here for you. Please be here for us. Support CMA and keep arts education thriving.